Chin-chin is a popular Nigerian snack. It can be fried and it can be baked. So today I'll be showing you how to make crunchy chin-chin from the comfort of your own. So I'll be using 1½ cup of all-purpose flour for this recipe. The next ingredient I'm using is butter. You can also use margarine. I'm using 75 grams of butter. So I'm going to combine the butter and the flour together. I'm going to fluff this together until the mixture looks like breadcrumbs. After combining the flour and the butter together, I'll add other ingredients: 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/8 cup of sugar, 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg, and I'm going to mix this together well. When I'm sure all ingredients are well mixed, I'm going to create a hole inside the flour and pour in my 1/4 cup of milk. This milk, I'm going to pour it in gradually. I'm not going to pour it at once. I'm going to pour it in gradually and mix the flour gradually. So at this point, I've poured in some quantity of milk. So I'm going to gently mix this together. Make sure you gently mix it. Don't mix it too rigorously. Just gently combine the milk and the flour together, except you want a hard chin-chin. If you want your chin-chin to be soft and crunchy, you have to gently combine the milk and the flour together. Like I said earlier, I'm mixing the milk in bits. When I feel I've exhausted the milk I added, I'm going to pour in more and mix again. So this is to help me get my dough right. I don't want a wet dough, because for chin-chin you're not working with a wet dough. So the total measurement of milk I used for this recipe was 1/4 cup of milk and 1 tablespoon of milk. That's the total milk I used for this dough. When I'm done with the mixing of the dough, it's time to flatten out and cut out our chin-chin. So I'll be needing a rolling pin and a rolling board. So I'm going to spray some flour on the board and cut the dough into two so that I can easily work with it. So the next thing I'll do is to flatten out the dough like I'm doing here. I'll be using a pizza cutter to cut out the chin-chin shapes. So the first thing I'll do is to cut out the rough edges. After cutting out the rough edges, then I go ahead to cut the chin-chin into my preferred sizes and shape. You can cut your chin-chin into different shapes and into different sizes. It depends on your preference. While I was busy cutting out the chin-chin, I had already placed the oil I used to fry the chin-chin on fire. I've placed it on medium heat. So to test the oil temperature, I'll go in with one chin-chin. So when it floats up, that means the oil is right for the chin-chin. So now it's time to transfer our chin-chin into the oil for frying. Don't worry about the chin-chin sticking together when they are not in the oil. When they get into the oil, everything is going to separate. They are not going to clump together. I just kept stirring this at intervals so it doesn't get burnt. and so that each side can be well fried. For you to know when your chin chin is well fried, the chin chin will start to sink to the bottom of the oil. That means your chin chin is ready to be scooped out of the oil. When your chin chin starts sinking into the oil, the chin chin is well fried. So this is the same thing I'll do to the second batch of my dough. I'm going to pour it in the oil and make sure it is well fried. And here is the final outcome of a sweet and crunchy, tasty chin chin. If you're looking to make a soft and crunchy chin chin, try this recipe and let me know your outcome in the comment section. If you have any question, you can drop it in the comment section and I'll give you answers. Thank you so much for watching. Till I come your way next time. Bye.